Greetings, true believers. Today I want to tell you about a book called AlphaRed by creator James Q. Nguyen. AlphaRed is a faith-based superhero story written and drawn by Mr. Nguyen. The story follows our protagonist, Calvin Wesley, who goes by the nickname Wes, who is a morally upstanding person and is recruited by an enigmatic organization called the Kingdom. Now, the Kingdom appears to have a few of the original apostles from the Bible. I don't know if all of them are present or not, but we already see Peter and John are there. And these are the original apostles, so they are very old indeed. And they recruit Calvin and give him the mantle of AlphaRed, and he is tasked with unraveling the machinations of the literal devil, Satan, who appears as a character in this book. There are strong Christian themes embedded in the core of the story and the settings and the characters, but the story quality is not compromised for the message. We don't see a ham-fisted set of vehicles for James Nguyen's worldview, in other words. This is a good story with good art, and I really enjoyed it. Now, the first issue is actually a proper origin story, which is nice. It doesn't go into as much detail as maybe it could have, but I have to think, after reading some of this, that that we'll see some of that in future stories if they are published. So now I ordered a physical bundle from James's Etsy store, and so I want to show you the physical things that I got. The first thing that I got, of course, are the physical books. Now here's AlphaRed number one, and pretty nice that they are autographed. I like that. I requested that he sign them, and so he did. So I enjoy that. And a nice fun thing is that the first four issues have these pinups that came with them, which was sort of homages to classic comic book covers from The Amazing Spider-Man. And that's the alternate pinup for number one. And a really nice bonus is that James did an original sketch that he sent me, you know, of the mighty Thor. Much appreciated, James. Thank you for that. And AlphaRed number two. Oh, also, I like that cover. I like that better than the first cover. Very cool. Also autographed. Just a quick peek inside, and you'll see quality of the print. These are nice books. I wondered for a while what the quality of print would be from Kablam, because, you know, I've seen their advertisements quite a lot, but I wasn't sure what kind of books they printed. Now I'm happy to say, you know, I would probably use their service depending on, you know, the cost factor. And here is the alternate pin-up art for that cover. Obviously, this artist is strongly influenced by The Amazing Spider-Man and Todd McFarlane. Yeah, certainly nothing wrong with that. Here's the one for issue four. I'm kind of getting out of order here, but easily recognized for the Amazing Fantasy tribute that it is. And here is here's the number three, which this is clever. I like this. It's a homage and a tribute to Amazing Spider-Man 300. And as you see, it's 003. So that's pretty cool. And here is the physical number three. Again, I love that they are all autographed. And you know, pretty nice looking books. And there's four. As you can tell, there are Easter eggs, references, and tributes to various characters, shows, and comic books from my youth. So I have to assume that James has also been a fan of those shows and comics and characters, too. So we probably grew up reading and watching many of the same things. Another interior preview there. Okay. There are some guest appearances from characters from other companies. One company that I've been meaning to pick up some books from but haven't done it yet is Aspire Comics. So a few of their characters make a guest appearance in here. So let's take a look at, I also bought the digitals because I just kind of wanted to get started reading them before I even got the physical books. But as life is, by the time I got around to this this review for these books, I got the physical books. So that was fortuitous. So very cool. So let's just take a look here at the some of the digital work. Again, there's the cover for number one. So just some things about the artwork. It's pretty good. It's pretty strong in most areas. There are some weaknesses that I'd love to see James improve on. His anatomy is pretty well spot on for the most part. Where he runs into a little bit of trouble, and this is totally understandable, especially for a one-man show. He's working by himself, of course. Faces, hands, and feet are kind of hard to dial in all the time, and he does a pretty good job for the generally speaking. But I feel like he could probably put in a little more time on some of these. And in this book, he had some a couple of different colorists, and you can see the difference in color style. I don't know what the circumstance was for this, but what I think would have worked really well would have been to use one of the colorists for the present day stuff. See how nice and vibrant that work is. And then when you get to the sort of the flatter, less vibrant colors, that really could have been used for some of the flashbacks that we have in the story here. So, but that's a minor point. We can take a look at the others here so you can get a better look at the art. Because, on the camera there, we got glare on the lights, and it's a little difficult to see some of the work. But really good work, nice action throughout. I really enjoyed, these transforming mecha suits are cool. At one point, he gets a supercar, and it was a short run with the supercar, but hopefully we'll see that return. The AlphaRed, I think they called it. These books were very reasonably priced. I think I paid $2.50 for the digital copies each, and the 5-issue bundle was, I want to say, $30 plus shipping. So pretty affordable. And also on his Etsy site, there are foil versions of these covers, if you prefer to collect something like that, or if you want to just be a completist and get the regular covers and foil covers. Overall, I'm glad I ran into James online. I forget which platform we met on. It may have been Facebook, but anytime I see comics in the username, in this case AlphaRed Comics, I just have to go check it out, and I'm glad I did. I enjoyed the books when I read them, and dealing with James was very pleasant. He was very very attentive to his customer service, and so I'm happy about that. He answered my questions. He was very glad to sign the books at my request. And they were shipped pretty quick. So I will include a link in the description, of course, for James's Etsy store, along with the full written review of these books. And I encourage you to go check them out. This is pretty good stuff. Like I said, it's a Christian book, but like some other Christian books that I've reviewed before, the story seems to be the priority and then the message. So these characters in this world does not exist simply to push the author's religion or worldview. So, and as I said before, I view these books through basically a secular lens because I want to evaluate them on their merits as comic books and as entertainment. And I like to say happily that Mr. Nguyen's work has passed that litmus test, and I look forward to seeing more from James and from AlphaRed in the future. So get out there and grab your copies. If you just want to get your feet wet, grab issue 1 in digital format and read that. That's kind of how I start with a lot of different titles. With this particular set of books, I just felt that it was a good deal right away, so I pulled the trigger and got the digitals in addition to that, because I like to have those on hand, especially for previewing the books in reviews. So high marks to James at AlphaRed Comics for AlphaRed, the comic series. And let's keep an eye on James, and let's hope he gets some more books out there. So thanks for tuning in. If you don't mind, give me a little like and subscribe and ding the little bell, if you would, so you'll get notifications. And I'll see you next time. Excelsior.